Good morning, dear children. Let us start with the next concepts of the chapter 7, congruence of the triangles. In the previous video, we discussed about the criteria of congruence of a triangle. We discussed about first two criteria, SSS, SAS. Now we have to start with the next three criteria. The very first is ASA. ASA stands for angle, included side, again angle. Why included side? Because this side is coming between two angles, therefore it will be called as included side. Are we clear? Now it states that if two angles are included side of a triangle are equal, it states that if two angles and included side of a triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and the included side of another triangle, then they are congruent. Please observe these figures very carefully. If you will see that there are two angles, yes or no? We are having 70, 70, 80, 80, 5 cm, 5 cm. Two angles and included side. Since this side is coming between two angles, therefore it is called as included side. Are we clear? So can I say, for example, I write in triangle ABC and triangle EFG. Can I say angle A is equal to angle E because both are 70 degrees? Yes. Now, can I include this side AB, EF? AB is congruent to EF and they are equal also 5 cm. Similarly, can I talk about angle E is congruent to triangle F and they are equal also, both are 80 degrees? Now, angle side angle. The two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding. They are corresponding angles, their corresponding side also, and equal. Therefore, can I say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle EFG? And what rule we have used? We have used ASA rule. Are we clear? Clear by this? Now, can you tell me, is angle C is equal to angle G? Yes, CPCT. Very important. I told you, CPCT. Therefore, even BC is equal to FG, CPCT. All the corresponding parts, the remaining corresponding parts are equal to each other by CPCTE. Even AC is equal to EG, again CPCTE. So what is the main difference between SAS, SAS, two sides and included angle was there? In this, two angle and included side is there. Next, AAS. In this, again angle and side. This side can be anything. Just observe the figure. Two angles are there, but we are not considering the side in between. Hence, we are considering the another side which is not in between. Therefore, AAS. So it says that if two angles and any side of a triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and any side of another triangle, then they are congruent. For example, again, very easy. Triangle ABC and triangle EFG. Can I write angle A is equal to angle E because both are 70 degrees? Again, can I write angle B is equal to angle F, both are 80 degrees? And now I am not taking the side included, I am taking another side. BC is equal to FG because both are 5 cm. Angle, any side. Therefore, the two triangles are congruent. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle EFG. What rule I have used? Yes, by AAS rule. Because I have considered any side, not the included side. Are we clear? Now, if we talk about, can I say angle C is equal to angle G? What is the rule? CPCT. Can I say AB is equal to EF? Again by CPCT, because all are corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Once we have proved the two triangles to be congruent, rest all the parts are equal. Yes. Then what is left? Okay, AC is equal to EG. Again, CPC. Are we clear? Anyone with a doubt in this? Anyone? So, how they are different? In this, this is the included side. In this, this can be any side. So, both are different congruency. Clear? Any doubt anyone is having? Let's move on to the last congruency, which is RHS. I hope you know the meaning of RHS. RHS is not right hand side, it is right angle hypotenuse and side. This side can be, understand, it can be base also or perpendicular. It doesn't matter, we are considering any side. Are we clear? So, RHS, first thing, RHS is always applicable in right angle triangles. So, right triangles, it is always applicable. Just observe the figure. Hypotenuse is the same in both the figures because it is the longest side. 90 degree is there, and the side perpendicular, both are 3. So don't you think RHS congruency is applicable in this triangle, to right triangle? Understand, it states that if hypotenuse and any side, I told you, it can be base also, it can be height also. Any of out of this, anyone is included, that's the rule. Of a right triangle are equal to the corresponding hypotenuse and any side of another right triangle, then these two triangles are congruent. For example, very important, again a right triangle ABC and triangle PQR. First thing, may I write, because it's talking about hypotenuse, so let's understand AC and PR are congruent to each other, corresponding parts or not. AC is equal to PR, both are 5 cm and both are hypotenuse. Any doubt? First condition is approved. Now, angle B corresponds to angle Q, both are equal and both are 90 degree. And right angle condition is also approved. Last, we should have any side. Let's consider AB, PQ. AB corresponds to PQ and both are equal also because both are 3 cm and they are perpendicular. It can be base also, not a problem. So don't you think it is fulfilling the condition of hypotenuse, 90 degree and any side? Hypotenuse, 90 degree and any side, and they are corresponding parts of each other and they are equal also. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to PQR by RHS congruency rule. By RHS congruency rule. Any doubt anyone is having? Now again we can put rest of the parts. Angle A must be angle P because CBCTE. Angle C must be equal to angle R, CPCTE, and definitely BC will be equal to QR, CPCTE, because both the triangles are congruent, the rest of the corresponding parts must be. Are we clear with RHS? By this, our congruency is over. But nobody asked me the question, sir, we have considered all things, we have considered even three sides, why not three angles? Why we are not considering three angles? I'll just explain you why we do not consider AA means angle. Just understand, it's very important that out of which what is not existing, which congruency does not exist, that congruency is AAA rule. It does not hold good. Understand why? I will show you things in front of you only. Right? I think you would have got the answer by now. By angles, these two figures seems to be congruent. Say 50, 50, 60, 60, 70, 70, no problem. But are they having same size? What about the length? If you are not considering the length could be anything. Then in that case, so one smaller triangle and one bigger triangle we can have. But are they covering each other? This triangle will not cover this triangle because it will come like this. What are the rest of the question? As per the congruency rule, the two triangles must cover each other completely, but they are not covering. That's why the AA criteria does not exist, because the side could be anything. Because in this case, size means I can be anything. Therefore, the size of two triangles may not be same, and hence they will not superimpose each other. Thus, AA congruency does not exist. Are we clear? So this congruency does not exist. Why? Because angles, no problem, they are congruent. But what about the side? Sides can be anything. One can be bigger, one can be smaller, but they are not able to superimpose each other. They are not able to cover each other. Then how can we say that they are congruent? Though the measurement of angles are equal, not a problem, 50, 60, 70, going perfectly with the rule. That measurement must be same. But what about the size? What about the size? What about the sides? That's why this AAA criteria does not exist. Are we clear? By this, your congruency chapters over here only. I hope you would have enjoyed the chapter. In the next chapter, we'll start with the comparing quantities. That in that, we'll study about ratio and proportion. We'll study about percentage, we'll study about profit and loss, we'll study about selling price, we'll study about the cost price, we'll study about the profit and loss, yeah, and beside that we'll be studying about the interest, that is the simple interest. Are we clear? Till then, take care, bye bye.